Hi, guys. Hey, listen, I got to thinking. 3D people every age pretty much are leaving. The ones that aren't probably are not going to listen to me. But there are people that listen to me that will be staying and playing the fourth dimensional game. So I thought, well, are any of you guys interested on how to play the fourth dimensional game? Y'all want to know how? All right, well, I'm going to tell you some things. Maybe I'll stick them in here time and ever so often. How about that? Remember that in fourth dimension, it was all about fear. Everything was based on fear. So the whole game was built on that scenario. So they got you drawn into the games of fear. You went to the school system so you could get enough education just in afraid that you would not. Got the right job, the most amount of money, marry the right person, have the right kids, live in the right country. I mean, it was the right religion. Everything was based on if you don't do this out of fear, you did this thing because of the fear. Okay? Now, in fourth dimension, like I said, it's all based on judgment. So what they're going to do is they're going to try to win you over. They'll win you over all kinds of ways. They can win you over with promises of dot, dot, dot. So the trick in fourth dimension to do it successfully is to understand what the game is. Number one, the game is you will be introduced, thus fourth dimension, you'll be introduced to time and space, being able to control, or beings that control time and space. So if you're going to stay and play, you need to, number one, not be shocked and shaken when you're introduced to these beings. People that are like, ooh, oh my, look at what they can do, they will be very easily controlled by the fourth dimensional beings that have been playing here for a while. If you expect that, then you won't be all ooh-ah-ooh over it, and they won't be able to just nab you right off the bat. Understand, if you go into fourth dimension with an understanding that this is a game and that you are a god, then you can start practicing creating stuff, which means you're going to call the aliens into your life that would be the best to serve you. So you don't want to argue with them. You don't want them to think that that their judgment ploys are not working with you. You're going to play the game. You're going to play the game. So in other words, you're going to use their judgment of you against them. Okay? That's the advantage to going into the fourth dimension, is you're going to get them to judge you, because either way, on either side of the fence, all of it is about judgment. Their side, your side, everybody's side is doing judgment, just like they did with fear in the third dimension. So you can use that judgment to your advantage, their disadvantage, if you're cautious about it. If you stay centered in the knowing that this is a game and that you want to play, then you can start playing from that perspective. And that's how you start getting them to judge you a certain way, by showing, you know, stating the intent of what you want and then waiting for it and then working yourself into that game in that way. So you want to, and really that depends upon how you want to play the game. If you want to be a captain of a starship, then you need to understand where you're coming from as a human being. You don't have the training to do that. So what you want to do as a creator god is you want to visualize that you find a smaller civilization, one that in the fourth dimension is less, that good starship captains aren't going to go and hang out at, that they want bigger and better ships. And from your perspective, you don't care if it's an older ship, you just want to fly a ship. So it's kind of like here, then if you want to be, if you want a job as a high-end job, then you're going to go to a smaller place. Let's say you went to school to be a doctor, but you didn't go to a highfalutin school. Well, you're not going to go to a city and go up against a whole bunch of other doctors that have these degrees from these colleges that people know the names of. Instead, you're going to, if you've got a college degree from a smaller school, a less well-known school, you can go to a smaller town and still be a very, very effective and respected doctor. Okay, well, you're going to do the same thing with this. You're going to intend, and then you're going to go to a more less known civilization that are up for putting the time and the money in to train a human, knowing that they are worth it, that then you've got to prove to them that you will put the time and the effort in to do it, because you'll be learning a lot of stuff really fast. And you can do that with anything. I mean, literally anything. In the fourth dimension, there are machines that will download information that you can learn how to fly a spaceship instantly. 30-second download and it's done. You can literally do that. So it becomes, they've got to judge you as being appropriate for the job, for their society, for their establishment. So you have to put yourself forward that you match that. So you're going to intend whatever it is that you want. And a lot of them do not see themselves as gods. And you can absolutely have the upper hand. Keep your mouth shut about it, though. Keep your mouth shut about it. But you can totally go into it knowing it's a game, knowing that you're a creator god, and going into it intending what you want, and it will be drawn to you just like it does here. You just got to go into it that way and be very, very clear about what you want. Do not go into it with any hint of fear, because those are the ones that will just whisk you over. If they can pull out that fear from your third dimension and keep you there, and they judge you and you just are kind of whatever, then you'll be drug into hither thither and be blown around like the wind, a leaf in the wind. But if you go into the fourth dimension from the standpoint that you're a creator god and it's a game, and you keep your creationary power intact but keep your mouth shut about it, then you'll be looked at by everybody around you as, oh, you're so smart, or you're so lucky, or whatever. You can totally go into that area. But do not be surprised about anything that's available out there. Don't judge anybody, because you'll be shown a whole lot of stuff. And if you go to a smaller place and their bells and whistles aren't as big and bad as the other ones you've noticed, then they won't want you there. So understand that you're coming into the game kind of behind times, and you're willing to go and get an apprenticeship with the younger one. Just because you get downloaded with the information is not the same as having the actual experience flying the spaceship around, because those are moment-to-moment decisions that have to be made. So you can learn how, but the actual doing it and who you're going to work for, you're going to work for who are you going to do this for? Are you going to do it for a planet, a country, a corporation, a universe? What do you want to do? Because there's lots and lots and lots of options. So you can figure out all that. Is there a lot to play there? Yep. Can you do it and have a lot of fun? You bet you can. And if that's what you want to do, then go in there with your eyes open and you can do it well and have a lot of fun. Okay? But don't follow like sheep. Don't follow the rest of your humans, because a lot of them won't be aware of any of this, and they're going to be caught up in something else. So you have to be pretty okay with being independent, like being the only human on a planet with the history that you've got. So if that bothers you, then 4D might not be the best place for you. But if you could do that kind of thing, if that sounds exciting and fun, you could totally do the fourth dimension with the stuff that I've told you about. And the other day on G-Man's site, somebody had asked, can you stay on the timeline that you're on if you like it? And yes, you can. In reality, there is no one timeline, but you can keep the feel of one. You can't hold still, because there's no such thing as time in reality. But you can keep the same feel of your life, so to speak. You can keep it fairly consistent. But, of course, nothing stays the same. Everything is changing. I don't know of anybody who wants to do that. Usually they want change in some regard. But if you didn't want change, if there is such a person out there, can you do it? Certainly. I would say it's just as challenging to keep things from changing as it is to change them. So you're not going to get anywhere. It's not going to become easier by holding something to a consistent way, because everything around you is changing so rapidly that to try to get it to stay the same around you will still be a tricky thing to do. But you can absolutely do it. You can do anything. You're a god. Okay, that's it for this one. Thank you so much for watching. Much appreciated. Anybody want to comment below, please do. Give me a thumbs up. Please subscribe. And yeah, I can't wait to talk to you again later. Love you bunches. Huge hugs. Bye now.